tantse se ba ka se go di medise bile go amogela mothulagong ya rona beke le beke ya spot on le thulagong ya itsedu alo ke mmiri channel le product a mmiri online alo maina ke kabelo borana bi and I'm a host for the show mothulagong ya letsatsi la gompieno alo re hostile alo a football expert and a football writer le ene Molefhi Obenne yalo e le an independent football expert alo bile a dira alo letsa go kwala dibuka yalo Molefhi o na le dibuka tse di published di le tharo at the stage yalo Obenne welcome to spot on this week.
Kabelo, let me take this opportunity to thank you for having invited me here and also let me also greet you, your viewer at home.
Topic ya letsatsi la gompieno ke buke ya pela ga rona ya The Biography of Major David Bright, yalo the former minister team coach yalo ebile a kile a coach le ditlhopha tse tharo kana tse kae tse mo latshe la rona go ka re motho a ka simolola go itsela gore why did we decide to honor the life of the late coach ka go kwala bukaro.
And the question is, who else should we honor? Because when you look at our football in the past, we haven't documented a lot of our icons locally. And you know, as I was journeying through my writing as a football author, I did Botswana Football, A Fool's Paradise Edition 1, Botswana Football, A Fool's Paradise, Another Day in Paradise, and then I did Botswana Football, A Fool's Paradise, My Father.
Yes.
So now this was me now departing from my father now to actually painting a picture of one of the fathers. And what a way to start with, you know, with the late Major David Bright. It's so unfortunate that I had to release it, you know, after he had passed on. And the book has been written over the years, especially when I was writing Another Day in Paradise. It actually gave me a lot of information during the write-up of that book. So, you know, as I was about to start about him now, he departed. And I said, at least I have something, because over the years I've documented a lot of stories for him. I even revamped his CV. You know, I even know about his journey, where he wanted to convert some of his coaching qualifications to the current ones, you know, and he was denied that. So now I said, let me write about this late old man who has actually contributed so much to Botswana football, and actually call him the root of Botswana football because he did a lot, man.
Nere ka thusa ditsela tse dintsi jalo tsa go honora kana go celebrata botshelo ba ga Major David Bright. Why did we write a book, not a movie, not a TV series or anything of that sort?
It's about who I am and what I can do. My starting point is a book in terms of the documenting part of everything. Okay. And we have shot a few snippets, you know, and we wanted to do a video documentary, which we have. And this book is a 13 milestone book or a 13 chapter book. So the documentary, it's there. And I want to believe we have around 7 episodes that we have actually shot, you know, with various people. But because some of the information we needed to verify it, then there was a delay in that. So, you know, the starting point was always, you know, put something in writing. You know, after you have put something in writing, you read this, you internalize it. That's when now you can picture a movie.
Yes.
So I want to believe, you know, we are getting there and we'll get there. And we still need a lot of people to actually come on board and assist us on how to put this amalgamation of work together, because this is a phenomenon individual. It's not only about us, but him. And, you know, we have always said there are so many stakeholders who, you know, who are part and parcel of Major David Bright, not only me, not only his family, not only the supporters, not only the coaches and the fans, but everyone else. You know, he has actually touched a lot of people, and we want to believe that everyone must play a part in this launch of his biography.
Yeah, talking about your biography, that's a documentation of the life and work of the late Major David Bright. Who are the highlights from the book? An ordinary football fan, or into the just snippet into the life of the late Major David Bright.
Major actually touched a lot of people's lives,
yes.
And that's what you are going to appreciate from the book. And, you know, there are a few things, you know, that maybe I might highlight, as you mentioned. You know, Major remains one of the few to have coached in South Africa.
Yes.
And Major remains the first Motswana coach to actually win a cup with the senior team, and that was in Swaziland.
Yes.
Measure remains the only Motswana to have won a cup in Asia, and this was with the dream yes. team. And Measure remains the only Motswana coach to have came closer to qualifying Botswana to the Olympics. Measure remains the only Motswana to have gone, and the only coach to have ever coached Botswana to go 10 games, unbeaten. You know, unbeaten. And, you know, no one else has ever surpassed that. Measure remains the only Motswana to have, you know, won three league campaigns with one team. And he remains the only coach to have coached for 13 years. With the same team. So there are a lot of things that you can actually learn from the Measure. Mm. And Measure, you know, he was not a good player. Mm. And he was injury prone during his time. And the reason why he became a good coach, as it was also put by KK and also Tebogo Sebego, is because, you know, when you are not so much of a good player, what you do is you look holistically at your team and you want to develop a team. Then wherever you are a good player, you're always looking for someone who will emulate you, or you want to coach players to be better than you, or you don't want players to be better than you, so that, you know, you always compare yourself with them. But with Measure, because he wasn't a good player, so he had to make sure that his team was actually balanced. Mm.
You're talking about a great man, a man of many firsts. How easy was it? Or difficult was it? Or how you have a document that was slowly to allow a major budget if you write it. Let's say through it, how the biography of Major David Bright.
You know, the journey started in 2019 when Major was still alive. Mm-hmm. So it was easy to, you know, even before that, it was easy to put together those pieces together. But after his departure now, it became very, very difficult. Mm. You know, it was a roller coaster of emotions. And the book, by 2021, you know, it was done after he passed on. And the big question was, when are we going to release the book? When is the right time? And, you know, over the years, the family also faced a few tragedies. You know, other people passed on. Last year, his son took his life. This year, the husband to the daughter also passed on. Mm. So there was never that time to say, can we do the launch for Measure? Mm. But, you know, by the grace of God, we said, when was Measure David Bright born? Mm. We said 13, which is also the magic number that we used to have to play around with the episodes.
Yes.
And because he was born on the 13th of June, mm. you know, on that day, We agreed with the family to say, let's celebrate Measure's birthday with the release of his book.
Yes.
You know, we're so lucky that, you know, at least we agreed on that to say, no, let this book be Measure's present on his birthday. So that's how we actually managed to do it on his birthday. And because there was no proper time to release it, mm. but then we find that appropriate moment to actually do it during his birthday.
Before you go for a short commercial break, can you hold up the book? I'll leave the camera. I will let you know what I'm going to do. Book, lift the prices.
Yes, this book can be found at Green Pantries in Extension 10, mm-hmm. Famous Campus Square Complex. It's unit number one. And then Lekaha Main Moloko Perfect Roast Coffee. Mm. And then Lekako Botswana Bookstore. The book goes for $250, except Lekako Bookstore, well, like $300. Mm. So those are the areas that someone can actually find the book, or they can contact me on 766-29133. They just WhatsApp me, I'll be able to help them with the delivery of the book.
With those words, I almost want to learn Molefhi Obenne kind of maya. Let's go for a break. Here, Tabak, but it's a piece of yarn. I'm not just saying.
Have you downloaded BW News app? your one-stop shop for Botswana's leading newspapers. If not, what are you waiting for? Start reading the print editions of Botswana's leading newspapers as they appear in the newspapers on any device. The BW News app features the Midweek Sun, Botswana Guardian, Mehi, and the Monitor, updated in an easy-to-flip-through format once the papers are printed. Our packages include current affairs, which creates seamless access for one organizational setup. You can add up to 100 users at affordable rates. After subscription, you will have access to our PDF archive from the past 1 year. You will also receive notifications on your phone as soon as the newspapers publish. You can open your favorite title and share it in text format, and also change the font size and screen light to your choosing. Too busy to flip through and read? The BW News app will read the article for you, and it can also translate from English to the language you're comfortable with. Get the BW News app from the Google Play Store and the App Store and enter a world of up-to-date news presented as it appears in the physical paper.
Thanks for that. See, go home. Mukhela, ha. People, get a lot of love. But some tweet is still on. I'm still on. I'm spot on. I'm looking at the Molefhi Obenne. I'm looking at a football author and a football expert. I'm looking at Molefhi Obenne. Get a lot of love. Go busy. Go Palapye. You are heading a project. I'm looking at teams are measuring up. I'm looking at a project. Get a lot of love. I'm looking at Palapye All-Stars. Palapye United. Palapye Swallows. Secondly, give us the tidbits of the whole major project.
I know how Tebo Letsile doesn't like to be the face of athletics.
Okay.
And I also wanted to decline to be the face of this project.
Of but since you are here now, there.
Yeah, but the guy said, you know, you are there, you are in the space, please be the face. And actually accepted this. So, but now it becomes a misconception. You know, people will think I'm the one who owns this project. Actually, yes, Molefhi, you know, Molefhi wants to, you know, to swallow up our teams and stuff like that. But I must say that in December of last year, when we were celebrating the festivities, I had a meeting with three gentlemen, Ron Khumela, Duncan Steady, and Mr. Letlotla. They came to me and they said, Molefhi, we are concerned with the state of football in Palapye over the past 10 years. We haven't seen much progress. Yes, of course, other people will think because you have Murupule that are in the Premier League, you know, you have Motlakase that are in the First Division, you know, that's progress. But where we are seated and where we are coming from, there ain't any progress. Because when you look at our traditional teams from Palapye, like teams from the originally from the community, like the old community teams, you know, with the natives, with the indigenous people, there isn't much progress. They said, where is Palapye All-Stars, where is this peak? Even though they are still new, Palapye All-Stars is 12 years old.
Yes.
Where is Palapye United? You know, they'll be celebrating, I don't know how many years. You look at Palapye Swallows, they'll be doing 85 years next year. Then they said, if we talk Murupule and Motlakase, you know, Murupule is bankrolled by Murupule coal mine.
Yes.
Motlakase now, you know, most of its contingent is actually from the power station. What about Palapye Swallows? What about Palapye United? What about FC Palapye? You know, can we come together and talk about this? And their proposal was, you know, can we do one team and you know, have one team that we can all support? They even threw in some names. And I said, you know, I appreciate your concern, and your concern is actually our concern. But first, let's do this, because you and I, we don't own football,
yes,
but football is owned by the people.
By everyone.
So what do we do? Let's go to the people, consult with them, yes, and then propose to them what we want to achieve. Because if we create a new entity, it will look like that's our own
project.
Yes.
It's but what, the people's project.
Exactly. What about the people? Hence why that tagline, Palapye People's Project. We went to Palapye Swallows, we went to Palapye United. You know, they were receptive of what we were coming with. And the people that we consulted at the time, they said, you know, the concerns that you guys are talking about is the same concerns that we go through year in, year out. Mm-hmm. And, you know, they even painted the history to say, when you go to Palapye Swallows, for example, nowadays, you know, there is nothing. Even when you talk rivalry between Palapye and Palapye Swallows, you know, that is dead. Yeah. You know, these teams, you know, they're in Division One. The past 10 years, they haven't achieved a thing. None of them has ever won a league. Mm. Except for Palapye Stars, because, you know, maybe Palapye Stars, you know, they go with the current trends. And I had to stop them to say, Palapye Stars is even a development team. Mm. The only time it goes up is when you guys are not serious. And, you know, the young boys, they come together, then they hammer everyone. But, you know, that's not Palapye Stars. Palapye Stars are supposed to remain, you know, there. That's why we'll go to first division. Mm. Then we relegate because we would have overperformed. Mm. So we did those consultations and, you know, initially, we were in sync with those that we consulted, especially the leadership of those teams. I can give you an example. In 2023, January, I went to watch Palapye United play against All Eyes on the Ball. And Palapye United, they had 8 players. And guess what? They won 6-0.
They won
6-0 with 8 players. And, you know, they would be happy for sure. And I'll be like, what is this? You can't have 8 players and you endeavor to go to first division.
Yes.
Are you going to play with 8 players? What are the reasons? Mm. And they said, no other players, you know, they stay outside. I was like, you see. Mm. That's why now we need to have a football conversation and talk about these problems. When this league starts, even now, Palapye Swallows will come to Palapye Stars. Can you loan us this player? Can you loan us this player? I'm like, you see, we're talking football and there's the same thing. Why can't we come together and have a conversation? And the measure that we are talking about, you know, what we are saying is we are not going to swallow any team. Mm-hmm. But what we are going to do is just to reconfigure the mandates of this team. Mm-hmm. And then we develop what you call a player path or player's trajectory. Mm. Palapye Stars will do grassroots. That is to say, from the age of 6 up to the age of 11, players will be trained at Palapye Stars. And Palapye Stars will never do under 15, will never do senior football. This will be Palapye Stars' mandate. Mm. And then on the development, when now a kid is 12 to 17, we give you to another team. Mm. We beat Palapye Swallows or Palapye United. Yes. They do this mandate of development. Mm. And then we have another team now doing the senior team. Mm. You see, this is how players progress, and everyone will still be existing with their own names, so they'll be still doing the annual returns. Mm. And we're not going to take anyone's property, because these clubs, they own properties. But because we put in this amalgamation of resources, ideas together, we're going to have a board that you know, will be representative of all these teams
that oversees
the whole process. Yes. You know, we even have community leaders as part of the board, because this is a people's project. It's no longer about Molefhi, it's no longer about Palapye Swallows, but everyone inclusive. So we made progress. We made strides, and we asked the other teams to go and consult, because the Palapye Stars management, I'm not in the management nowadays, but they said, you know, we will do development because we have been, no, rather we'll do grassroots from 6 to 11, and then we can allow the other teams to choose which mandate they can agree to do. So we have been in and out, and we're having a meeting tomorrow, which is a virtual meeting with the reps to hear what they have said to the clubs, because we've been doing a lot of meetings in between. We even did a survey on Facebook. Mm. You know, we asked the questions. We asked the people if they're happy with the status of football in Palapye. Mm. And at the time, I think there was 450 people who voted. 96% of them said no. We asked them if they were happy with the performance of the clubs. Mm. 97% of them said no. Mm. You know, we asked if they would like to see these teams imagine to be one team. Mm. And 96% of them were said yes. Mm. And we asked if they would like these teams to be assisted, you know, one by one. Mm. They said no, we want a measure. Mm. So it's not Molefhi's idea, it's not Duncan Steady's idea, it's not Ron Comella's idea. Mm. But it's everyone's idea and it's everyone's concern. So that's why we said this is a people's project. But you see, because football is all about opinions, we always have dissenting voices. But the problem is, do people understand where we want to go? Mm. If they do, then we can achieve a lot together.
Project on ebile, hopefully by next week, we are something tangible. So that we are now. This is it already.
Yes, there were options. The first option was to do that, to give each team mandate within the measure to say do grassroots, you do development, you do senior football, and then we have a body that will oversee that. You know, amongst the three teams, we can still have two teams if they agree. If we fail, then what is going to happen is we're going to reconfigure Palapye Stars. Now, Palapye Stars is a company. We will have it as a public company, not a private company. Okay. And then everyone who has agreed to this idea, whether they're coming from those teams or wherever they're coming from, they'll be, you know, part of the board now. So we're going to appoint them as part of the board of directors of Palapye Stars so that we continue with this project that we wanted to do. You know, if people want to come at a later stage, we'll still welcome them. But we hope that people will agree to this proposal of us having grassroots and overseen by one team, a development overseen by one team, and then senior footballer overseen by one team.
All right. Ele kana me abuya lo re ko Palapye ba busy ba bankanya bolo ko Palapye ba batla gore gone le a proper development structure, so a proper transition from the grassroots to team development, from team development to senior team, re bone team etswa ko Palapye ka letla go dominate etla go ira ya yalo on elite food league football allo er boya lo kana short break re tla tswala le pisa ya rona le re Molefhi kana me ya Obenne.
Do you want to stay in touch with the up-to-the-minute breaking news, countrywide, regional and international coverage, as well as in-depth analysis from Botswana's most trusted media house? Then head over to www.mekgi.bw, where you can also enjoy access to premium articles, long reads, features and exclusive opinions. Whether you're looking for updates on politics, health, education, business and the economy, or sports, and many more, we have you covered. Sign up on the website and choose a package suitable for you. We also have packages for organizations at affordable rates. Visit www.mekgi.bw and enjoy the finest journalism and news you need to know.
Welcome back to Sport Donor. This is a football expert, a football author, Molefhi Obenne, kana mea yalo. Ritola loka pisanya rona. Kana mea, you have been recently invited to Sevilla, Spain, for the World Football Summit from 18 and 19 September yalo. This is not the first time, right?
Yes, this is not the first time.
And arli bila loko ko football World Football Summit, the lead administrator, the lead expert yalo. Kuira galang sinja sinja from a dinner remote other perspective. Hori.
You know, the World Football Summit, they say this is where the football industry meets. And they will tell you that this is where we define the future of football. Because it's, you know, different experts, it's different players in the game, policy makers, and guys who have worn the T-shirt, you know, guys who have walked the walk, who have walked the talk. And you know, they come together and they learn from each other. The first time I participated in the World Football Summit was the World Football Summit Africa, which was in Durban, and I was actually a panelist there. You know, we're talking about new ways to improve sports revenue using technology. You know, monetizing your Facebook, monetizing your social space, and you know, even developing apps. Of which is something that when I came back, because I sit as the chairman of the Botswana Football Transformation Technical Committee.
Yes.
You know, we wanted to bring such ideas into Botswana to say this is what we have learned. Therefore, can we do 1, 2, 3? Yeah. And this is where now you'll actually appreciate that the world is moving. Yeah. And you know, in 2023. I was actually in Istanbul. We were doing the Football Innovation Forum. And, you know, it was technology advancement, you know, where there was an example where we were talking of advertising from your 2D to 3D, now to motion videos. To say, for example, you know, they want to introduce advertising when a player celebrates. Instead of you having this T-shirt written Botswana Football, a Fool's Paradise, you can actually play so many adverts in this t-shirt because it will be focused on that player, you know, for that moment. Remember, the players will take off their shirts, what, but this time it will be deliberate and the player will maybe...
So advert, so they
know, yeah, all the adverts, then they'll be playing, exactly, they'll seize that moment. So it's issues like that. And then Sevilla, at the time, you know, they presented what they are doing at the stadium. To say now they've created a home away from home, you know, where parents are able to bring kids, you know, the hospitality now has improved. They spoke of access control on how, you know, people use technology to go to the stadiums. It's no longer about that ticket. You know, you buy a ticket, the barcode is in your phone. As you walk into the stadium, it beeps. Wherever it is, man, it beeps once, then you are into the stadium. If it makes a lot of noise, then no go back, you know. So things like that. And, you know, you start to appreciate a lot to say, where are we as Botswana? We need to be closer. We need to be somewhere, you know, in this ecosystem, mm-hmm. and we need to contribute to that level. So now we are going to Sevilla. You know, this is another platform. It's over 2 days now. Mm-hmm. We're going to learn a lot, and we're going to dissect a few things. You know, the latest trends. We're going to talk about the money leak. Mm-hmm. You know, we're going to, and I want to believe the other discussion now is going to be that Qatar. You know, mm-hmm. how those Saudis now they're into football, and you know, there will be a discussion around that so that we learn from what they're doing, how we can actually protect football. So there's always a lot to learn from these summits. You know, you meet different people, they propose technologies, and the question is our country receptive to this? If I can take you back, we actually initiated the e-ticketing system in 2010. We are the ones who pioneered the e-ticket system. After we came from school, you know, Ghana's actually helped us with that. But, you know, because our football is full of people who are hungry, you know, they will not want to have most of 100% of their tickets sold through the system. Mm-hmm. They always want money into their pockets. Exactly.
Yes.
You know, most of our administrators, you'll think they are supporting the teams, but the teams are actually supporting them. If that is not the case, ask that person to leave. They will not want to leave. So in terms of technology advancement, you can answer that question.
I was to ask you, Bidawari, in terms of our football administration, through engagement with the world's best, the administrators. I'm not talking about the persons, the players. How far are we?
I have to admit, I'm also one of them. I have to say we are still far. If the world is at 100, we are still at around 20. Mm-hmm. Yes, of course, people will say, you know, there's a lot of technology that is being used, but are we embracing the technology, and are we using the technology the way it's supposed to be used? Mm-hmm. I'll give you an example now. You know, we have this FIFA Connect thing that we have in place where we register players, and you look at the hassle that teams go through, you know, at that level. Like, you know, you're supposed to use your phone and stuff like that.
Maybe it's at the FIFA Connect.
FIFA Connect, yes. You know, is the FCM, FCMS system. So people are struggling, and, you know, when people, they've put the data into the system, the response for them to take them to the next stage takes forever. You can have a player pending for a good 3 months in the system. You know, you can have the league starting and you have not finished registering your player, and then it will depend upon whom you know at BFA who can help you with that. But at the Premier League level, they will say, no, everything is run smoothly. But what about at the regions, because this is where we are developing football. Some teams, they end up with 12 players, but they will say, we have put this player in the system. So, you know, that's a yardstick that you can actually use to say, have we embraced the technology the way we said we have? And it will say to you, no, we haven't, and we are still very far. You know, and even that system you know, in other words, it used to actually manage matches. It manages referees. You remember how Bondo apparently was suspended because he didn't submit a particular report.
Yes,
so
yes.
You actually say someone in Palapye who is a coach is supposed to use the very same system, you know, to submit a report. But you're not doing that. So you're only doing it for registration purposes. But in terms of now the management of the league, the management of the matches, we're not doing that. So we're still fine.
So I normally fear football is going to fold, is going to pause at the 14th of September, just 2 weeks. How do you believe from an administrative point of view, particularly to the three gentlemen, Baba Emet, the studio sub president, Dr. Homwe, but to the Bataji thing, the moment about the move fishing, kind of Baba campaign or Baba promise about what from administratively?
It's a tough one because you remember the current president, when he got in, he said he's going to clean the mess for good 4 years, then he leaves. Mm. And then when he was supposed to leave, he said the mess was just too much, so he needs another term. I don't know what is the reason now. Is the reason to say, no, let me finish off my work. I don't know, you know. Mm. So now I get confused. And
but administratively, but you think Hakai in
oh yes, thank you, thanks for that. Mm. I mean, administratively, I think we're still lacking. You look at the coaches, you know, they've advanced more than the administrators,
yes.
And now it becomes difficult for someone to control someone who's educated. Mm. You know, you can't tell me what you are not.
Yes.
That's what they say in English. Mm. So we need to concentrate more now on administrators' education.
Yeah.
We need to concentrate more now on even the young ones, the ones that we are bringing up. Mm. You know, we give them options to say, do you want to be a referee? Do you want to be a player? Do you want to be a coach?
Mm.
You know, do you want to be an administrator at a young age? So we need to impart a lot of education. Yes, or a middle officer. We need to impart a lot of education in these kids as early as possible.
Mm.
But when you look at it now, there's a gap now. The coaches, they have diplomas. You know, our administrators, they use what they know and what they think they know. Only when they come into class, they'll be like, no, this is so wrong.
Mm.
So we need to close that gap. I want to believe, you know, going forward, we need to do that. So there's facilitation. Once you have facilitation, whatever you want to introduce, if it's a change, you have already prepared the ground for this change and people understand what you want
to do. Your final words on based on the book, your trip to Sevilla, Spain, everything about our conversation?
Yes, the book, we're actually doing mini launches so that, you know, every stakeholder, they have a say.
Mm-hmm.
We did the players with FUB, we did the coaches with Coaches Association, we did the media, and then we are doing the officials, you know, and then later on we're going to do supporters.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll see if we can take it to Botswana Defence Force. But then on the 28th of November,
mm-hmm.
that's when we'll be doing a big launch, mm-hmm. you know, for the book. It will be held at the Botswana Museum, an amazing place, I must mention. And then, you know, me going to Sevilla, it's not because of me, but it's because of Botswana. And when I go there, I represent Botswana. And whatever I say, I need to be very careful. When I get there, I'm not going to tell them that our league is dysfunctional. No, I try to promote our football as much as possible.
Mm.
Even though I've written a book to say Botswana football is a fool's paradise,
yes.
That's the truth. And you must understand the angle that I was writing from.
Mm.
And, you know, I also wish whoever will be taking over as the Botswana president, whether it's Maseo Nchingane, Tona, Babitsing, or it's actually McLean Quarteza, Litchit. I wish them well, and I hope you know, they will contribute immensely to the development of football in Botswana.
Obenne, kindly, role of accept the next time.
Thank you, sir, and I really appreciate your moment, and I'm truly humbled for having shared this moment with you and your viewer.
All right. Mutsane tsho pilar khagana ga kolagala re the senior national team ya bora the Zebras ba in action this weekend allo Maras rally behind the team re ko maritini on Saturday away ko maritini yalo ile another 2026 World Cup qualifier salo on Tuesday evening re ka go gate to the city of everything pressure salo ko Francis Town obeti tani chilume stadium at Rostila ba repeto Egypt Marter Teresa rally behind that team yalo ke kabelo borada from Sport One ke ya go leboga ba ile ke from today's show. Thank you.